हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम अगेन इन द वीडियो लेक्चर ऑफ क्लास 8 इंग्लिश ग्रामर. स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रीड अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑफ इंग्लिश ग्रामर, दैट इज फ्रेजल वर्ब्स. स्टूडेंट्स, व्हाट आर फ्रेजल वर्ब्स? फॉर नोइंग व्हाट इज फ्रेजल वर्ब्स, लुक एट द फॉलोइंग सेंटेंस. The first sentence, student, look at that cat. Second one, I climbed up the stairs. Third one, things are starting to look up at the school. Students, in the first sentence, the word look refers to directing one's eyes towards something as to see it. So, the sentence is written here, look at that cat. Second one, student, in the second sentence, up refers to a direction. And in the third sentence, student, in the third sentence, look up means to become better. Things are starting to look up at the school. So, student, we get here that such multi-word verbs are called phrasal verb. So here in the third sentence, what is look up? The third sentence, look up is the multi-word, means there are two words, look and up. So these multi-word verbs are called phrasal verb. Student, a phrasal verb consists of a verb and a particle. So what is the particle here? The particle can be a preposition or an adverb. The particles can either be a preposition or an adverb. So here, student, what is the particles we have got? The particle is up, and here up is what? Up is a preposition here. So, student, we have got here the definition. A phrasal verb consists of a verb and one or more particles that combine to create a meaning distinct from that of its individual constituent. So, student, here in the third sentence, the meaning of look up is different from the meaning of look at the first sentence. So, the definition is correct here, that a phrasal verb consists of a verb and one more particle. So here the verb is look and the particle is up, and the meaning is different from the first sentence. Students, some more examples are given here of phrasal verb. Come on here. Number one, would you like to come out for dinner tonight? So here what is come out? Come out is phrasal verb. Second one, you must abide by the rules of this institution. So what is abide by here? Phrasal verb. Third one, can you please go over my assignment once before I submit it to the teacher? So what is go over here, student? Go over is phrasal verb. So student, based on the structure, phrasal verb can be classified into two types. What are the types here? Number one, phrasal verb that consists of a verb and adverb. For example, phrasal verb that consists of a verb and an adverb. For example, Thomas tends to run away. So away is what here? Adverb. From his responsibility. So the first category is what? Phrasal verb that consists a adverb. That consists an adverb. And the second one is, student, phrasal verb that consists a preposition, verb and preposition. Here verb and adverb, and here verb and preposition. For example, the detective requested some more time to look into. So what is into here? Preposition. And what is away here? Adverb. So student, we have got here that there are two types of phrasal verb. Number one, where there is verb and adverb, that is one phrasal verb, and second one, when there is verb and combination of verb and preposition, that is the another one. Student, a prepositional phrasal verb is the combination of a verb and preposition. Unlike a phrasal verb, the meaning of prepositional verb remains more or less discernible from its constituent word. So, student, here it's the meaning is different from the constituent word, and that is where there is verb and preposition. They are also called as prepositional verb. Some more examples are given here, student. Here there are two examples, one of prepositional verb and one of phrasal verb. Number one example, the man stared at the kitten. Stared at. So what is here? Stared at. Stared at is prepositional phrase, because stare is verb and at is preposition. Now second one, student, you should stop staring people down. So staring down is what? Phrasal verb, because here staring is verb and down is adverb. Now student, we have to find out some phrasal verb in the following sentence. So in the first sentence, what is the phrasal verb here? The phrasal verb is dozes off. Second one, student, Tashneem comes across as a very ambitious girl. So comes across is phrasal verb. C number, I ran into Trisha at the supermarket yesterday. So ran into is the phrasal verb here. Number four, D student, why don't you cheer up and just enjoy the moment? So what is cheer up here? Phrasal verb. Number E, passenger ought to check in at least 2 hours before their flight departs. So what is check in here? Phrasal verb. Number F, I wonder when he will finally grow up and begin to take responsibility for his action. So here student, grow up and begin to. There are two phrasal verb. Number G, students, Danny is looking for his puppy. He has been asking around about it. So looking for and asking about. Asking about, here it is phrasal verb. Number H, my interest in stamp collection has died out. So died out is phrasal verb. I guess I should gear up. So what is gear up? Phrasal verb. So student, with the help of this exercise, we have got that in the sentence how the phrasal verbs are used. Now student, look at the sentences here, how it is used. Sentence number one, the villagers called the celebration off when the chief fell sick. Second one, student, I decided to call off the meeting as I was not completely prepared. Number third, student, Shamila realized she was allergic to lychee as her skin broke out in a rash after she ate some. So student, in the first sentence we have got that in the first or the second sentence there is the use of call off. But the meaning is same. What is the meaning of call off here? Cancel. The meaning of call off is cancel here in the first sentence and in the second sentence. The villagers called the celebration off means the villagers cancelled the celebration when the chief fell sick. And second sentence, student, I decided to call off the meeting. So again here I decided to cancel the meeting as I was not completely prepared. So student, we have got that phrasal verb. We have got, student, that phrasal verbs that can be broken apart while still keeping the meaning intact are called separable phrasal verb. Students, when the phrasal verb can be separated, it is called separable phrasal verb. For example, in the first sentence, called off is written separated, and the second sentence, call off is written together. But the meaning is same in the first sentence and in the second sentence. But the third sentence, student, in the third sentence, the phrasal verb broke out is used. It is used to indicate something unpleasant has suddenly started. If the verb that and the participle are separated in this case, the meaning will be affected. And that's why student broke out is not possible to separate it. So that's why these phrasal verbs are inseparable phrasal verb. So student, we have got here that there are two types of phrasal verb can be used, separable and inseparable. Some more examples are given here, student. For example, I get up. So get up is inseparable because we can't write get up separated. So it is called inseparable phrasal verb. Now next one, student, turn off. Here turn off is used in the first second sentence or third sentence. So don't forget to turn off the television. So turn off means here, student, switch off. And again in the third sentence, turn the radio off. Here again the meaning is switch off. So turn the radio off before you go to sleep. So here in the both sentence, the meaning are same. That's why they are called separable phrasal verb. Means turn off can be used together and turn off can be used separated also. So student, here we have learned that there are two types of phrasal verb. Inseparable phrasal verb that cannot be separated and separable phrasal verb that can be separated. Students, here there are some common separable and inseparable phrasal verbs. So with the help of this table, we can get it clear. Separable phrasal verb. So what are the separable phrasal verb and the meaning is not changed? First one, clean up. Second, make up. Third, fill out. Throw away, calm down, get across, turn off, pick up. So these are separable phrasal verb. And inseparable phrasal verb, student, carry on, look after, get along, throw up, come over, show up, go back, pass out. So these are what? These are inseparable phrasal verb. So all of you learn this separable and inseparable phrasal verb and use it in the sentence. Here are student two things to keep in mind while using phrasal verb. Number one, student, what is the important thing we have to keep in mind? The verb undergo change according to the tense and number. According to the tense and number, we have to change the verb. But there is no any change in the participles. Particles. Student, there is no any change in the particles. For example, student, one example is given here. You should not make up excuses to fool people. So here make is used. Why, student, make is used? Because here the helping verb is should. So after should, what we are using? V1 we are using. So make is written here. But in the next sentence, why would you believe the story she made up? So here V2 is used because the sentence is written in past tense. But student, one more thing we have to notice here, that up in the first sentence and up in the second sentence, there is any change? Is there any change in up? No. So we got here, student, that we will change the verb according to the tense and number, but we will not change the other particles like up in this phrasal verb. So when the phrasal verb make up change its tense, it becomes made up and not made up. Made up is wrong here. There will be no change in up. Students, now there are some second point here, students. Substitution of particle by another in a phrasal verb completely change its original meaning. For example, consider the verb pull. Student, in one verb, we can make so many phrasal verbs with the help of different particles. So here we have taken the verb pull. So what is the meaning of pull, throw, and the meaning is changed? What is the meaning of pull, throw? To survive or recover. What is the meaning of pull down? To demolish something, usually a building. What is the meaning of pull off? To achieve something. What is the meaning of pull up? To stop a vehicle. So student, we have got that with the help of one verb, we can make so many phrasal verbs with the help of different particles. Now there is one exercise before us. Look at the exercise, students. Exercise 2. Fill in the blanks using appropriate particles from the given bracket. One has been done for you. So number 1, student, let's put aside our disagreement for now. So here, put aside is the phrasal verb. Number 2, Priya asked around. Here there are two options, around and out. So around is the correct option. Number 3, my mobile data has run out. So run out is the correct option. I should recharge it soon. Now number D, student, the student looked through their notes before the exam. Now number E, student, why don't you join in on the fun? The more the merrier. So join in is the correct phrasal verb. So student, we have find out here the correct particles of the verb to make a phrasal verb. Now some more examples are given here. Number F, human beings can't do without. So do without is the phrasal verb. Do without is the phrasal verb. Number G, the keynote speaker dragged his speech on. So speech on is the correct phrasal verb. Number H, students, Karishma bounced back. So bounce back is the correct phrasal verb. That's why back is the correct option here. To health faster than anyone accepted. So student, in this exercise we have got that what are the particles and how particles are used to make a correct phrasal verb. So this is the first part of this video lecture, student. I will come with another part, part 2 of phrasal verb, and there will be some different rules of phrasal verb there. So thanks for watching the video. Keep watching my videos, students.